More than a dozen ships are waiting to pass through the Suez Canal. That's one of the world's busiest trade routes. This comes after a container ship ran aground blocking the canal. Well, the Ever Given ran into high winds and a dust storm, which made navigation difficult. At last check, tugboats are making some progress in freeing the boat. Well, our emerging markets editor, John Defterios, takes a look at how such an incident could happen.
A traffic jam on one of the most important waterways in the world. The Suez Canal was blocked on Tuesday when a very large container carrier got stuck, preventing other vessels from moving in either direction along the crucial east-west trading route that waves around 12% of world trade. Sailing under the flag of Panama, the Ever Given ran around 6 nautical miles from the southern end of the estuary. 400 meters long and 59 meters wide, the giant vessel got caught navigating through a sandstorm. The crew reported no injuries and no damage to cargo.
They're able to get, you know, diggers out to just dig out the sand, and hopefully that'll allow a little bit of room to pull the bows around, and then we can free this ship, and hopefully it'll be able to proceed on its way along with everything else.
8 tugboats are attempting to refloat the ship, according to the Suez Canal Authority. A senior canal pilot tells CNN that the process could take 2 days to a week and doubts the ship can sail and will need to be dragged. Nevertheless, the senior pilot believes once floated, there will be 2 to 3 days of ship congestion before things are flowing normally. Analytics from Port Texas said that 10 oil tankers carrying 13 million barrels of crude, about 14% of daily demand, could be affected by the delay. Nearly 19,000 ships, on average more than 50 ships per day, passed through the canal last year. A man-made engineering marvel, the busy Egyptian shipping lane is the quickest maritime link between Asia and Europe, at least when unobstructed. John Defterios, CNN, Abu Dhabi.
Well, Richard Mead joins us now for some expert analysis. He's the managing editor of Lloyd's List and covers all aspects of the maritime industry and global trade. Good to have you with us.
Thanks for having me.
So in terms of just how busy this trading route is, it takes fuel, food, manufactured goods. About 12% of global trade passes through this. What did you make of it when you saw this tanker, massive tanker, that seems completely wedged in the middle of the canal?
With an unprecedented situation, we have seen a number of groundings in the canal over the years. 2016, we saw a bulk ship similar to this one blocking the southern transit route. But the difference there is they're much more. This is a huge bulk ship. It's one of the biggest operating container ships in the world. If you imagine the boxes that your viewers are going to see on the back of trucks and motorways, these are what we call TU, 20-foot equivalent unit. This ship has 20,000 of them. It is enormous. It's one of the largest ships. And therefore, this is a really seismic, big operation to actually shift out of the carrier. It really is well truly grounded. But the question is going to be how long it takes to clear this. It takes a couple of days. That will be absorbed very easily by the industry. If it's longer than that, we're going to see a significant amount of global trade being rerouted at a significant expense. And that could be a problem.
Yeah, we're certainly already seeing that the oil markets are spooked by this at this very early stage. So the ramifications obviously going to be much bigger if this takes much longer than hours, but certainly days.
Yes, I mean, that's the current thing that the industry is weighing up. Do the sort of backing up at both ends of the canal wait on the assumption that this is going to take a couple of days to clear congestion, or do they start rerouting around Africa? That will add days, a significant amount of money in terms of the fuel bills to trade. It will cause a huge amount of delays to global trade. And nobody really wants to do that, but at the moment, it's a bit of a standoff. Nobody really wants to make a bet until they see what's happening. Now, you said that there is some movement in the ship, and we heard those reports as well, but I've heard from the technical manager who says that ship is well and truly stuck, it's not been partially refloated. still very much there. So we have to see what happens at the high tide and see whether the salvage are able to move the ship.
Yeah, hopefully the high tide does indeed help. Richard Mead, we have had some technical issues just trying to hear you, but good to have you with us. Appreciate it.
Jess, thank you.